Hi, everybody. I am Peter Travers, movie critic for Rolling Stone, and you're expecting me to tell you what's out there at the movies this weekend. And you know what? I'm not going to do it. I'm just not going to do it because it's time. Are you ready for fall movie preview? Yes, it happens all the time. Last week, we looked back on the summer. Now we look ahead to fall. There's 110 movies out there. There are also, because this fall is all about the Oscars, because the Academy has made 10 spots instead of 5 for Best Picture. In a year, which so far is pretty thin, I don't know how they're going to fill it. But anyway, I've seen some of these fall movies. I've seen pieces of some of them, and some I haven't seen at all. And you see my friend the scumbucket next to me? There are just some movies that strike me as worthy. Remember the Seinfeld show where Elaine would go around about talking about guys who were sponge-worthy? For me, I'm going to talk about movies that are scumbucket-worthy too, but I've just put their names on cards so that I can go through this and tell you what's out there. And the first card I have here is Avatar, because look, Avatar is James Cameron's first movie since Titanic in 1997. The man's been futzing around forever with 3D. I saw about 40 minutes of this movie. The trailer sucks, looked like nothing, but the stuff in 3D, spectacular. And look, since the Oscar went last year to a little movie like Slumdog Millionaire, I think the Academy is desperate for a big, giant, $200 million movie to come out there and work. And this is the movie. It's Cameron's Best Picture Oscar to lose. So I'm saying Avatar should be watched, looked for, and I'm excited about it. Then the other big moneymaker will be the Twilight Saga, New Moon. You all know this is the second of the four Twilight books, and this time Bella Swan, played by Kristen Stewart, has to decide between Rob Pattinson or Taylor Lautner, who is playing a werewolf. You know, I look at that and I say, should it? You know, remember how really lame the first movie was despite all the money it made? But maybe. So I'm putting this in the Cuber pile because maybe I'm just curious and so are you. Then Sherlock Holmes. Sherlock Holmes is a movie with Robert Downey Jr. playing kind of a hip happening, and now Sherlock Holmes with Jude Law as his Dr. Watson. That sounds terrific, but it is directed by the ex-Mr. Madonna Guy Ritchie, so you think, no, I'm still going to see it. Surrogates. Bruce Willis looking like he's doing an uncredited remake of Total Recall with a bad blonde wig.
It's true.
If you look at the trailer, that wig, scumbucket going right in there, sight unseen, sorry. Up in the Air, George Clooney playing a guy who travels around the United States firing people, so topical. From what I've seen, this looks like a definite nominee for Best Picture, and maybe even Clooney's performance of his career so far, so that stays in the list. Antichrist, you all want a nice movie by a true maniac like Lars von Trier, and in this movie, Willem Dafoe, and he just runs around the forest basically mutilating his genitals. No, sorry. Precious. Precious is that little movie, you never heard about it, you probably didn't hear much about anybody in it, directed by Lee Daniels, about a morbidly obese Harlem teenager who tries to find herself. It sounds like Hallmark. Not. It's great. I've seen the whole thing. Put it down. Write it down somewhere. Precious. When it comes out, you're seeing it. 2012. This is Roland Emmerich, the guy with always destroying the world. Independence Day is now destroying it again because in 2012, everything is supposed to go, and John Cusack watches these really tacky special effects with everything going. I've had it. Not interested. Scumbucket, you go right in. The Road is at least post-apocalyptic. Cormac McCarthy book, Viggo Mortensen and his son running around looking for something and an earth that's been destroyed. You're going to say depressing? I don't care. It was a great book. I am looking forward to that movie. And Education brings us a new star, Carey Mulligan, 23 years old. Take my word for it. The movie's great, but she's even better. You never heard her name? Too bad for you. This is a new major star, and just think, when you hear an Education, it's not Homework, it's a great movie. Two really incredible directors are taking on kids' movies. The first one is Spike Jonze, we all know him from being John Malkovich, doing Maury Sendak's Where the Wild Things Are. Visually, just amazing. And then Wes Anderson, the guy who gave us Rushmore and Royal Tenenbaums and the Darjeeling Limited, has taken on Roald Dahl's wonderful, fantastic Mr. Fox, with George Clooney doing the voice of Mr. Fox, and Meryl Streep is his wife. Stop motion animation, the hardest thing to do. Seeing this movie could not be better. Great young directors doing good things. Ah, look at this. Saw 6. Are you kidding? Enough already. Ah, geez, please. Capitalism, A Love Story is Michael Moore back taking on the crap that has happened to our financial system, making a citizen's arrest on the AIG board of directors. Has to be seen. 9. Another big musical by the director of Chicago, which won the Oscars Best Picture, and there's a lot of beautiful women, Penelope Cruz, Kate Hudson, Marion Cotillard, and as the Italian director who is singing and dancing, are you ready for this? Daniel Day-Lewis as an Italian, as a singing, dancing director? But still, there will be blood, please. I'll drink your milkshake. I'll drink it up. I'm going to drink up this movie. This is it. All the documentary footage of Michael Jackson rehearsing for that last concert he was never able to do. Sounds macabre. It sounds like we're being exploitive just to watch it, but you know what? We're going to watch it. Amelia is Hilary Swank going for her third Oscar, playing the aviatrix Amelia Earhart, sounding very, but still. Whip It. Whip It is Drew Barrymore's directorial debut with a lot of roller skating girls. There's Kristen Wiig. There's, I don't know. Brooklyn's Finest. Richard Gere, Ethan Hawke, Brooklyn Cops. Doesn't it sound great? People, I've seen Brooklyn's Finest. major scumbucket. For the holidays, Christmas Carol, Jim Carrey as Scrooge. You think that's perfect? Well, no, because they decided that wasn't enough. They were going to do one of those awful Polar Express versions of it where they just put these little dots on Jim Carrey. And from what I could see of it, he's got those dead eyes like they always do when they do that. Not interested in A Christmas Carol at all. Sorry. If Jim Carrey did it himself, great. How about The Imaginarium of Dr. Parnassus? Easy for me to say, as it wasn't. This is the last movie Heath Ledger did, and we know that he died while he was still making it, so Johnny Depp had to come in to help finish this movie for Terry Gilliam. From what I've seen, this could be the movie that could win Heath Ledger yet a second posthumous Oscar, so how would you miss that? Never. Lovely Bones, Alice Sebald's novel about a little girl who is raped and murdered, and watches from the heavens to see her parents try to catch the killer. The big draw here, Peter Jackson is the director. You think he can only do Lord of the Rings? Go look at what he did with Heavenly Creatures, amazing stuff. Invictus is Clint Eastwood directing a movie about Nelson Mandela starring Morgan Freeman. Need I say more? This screams Oscar. Tree of Life brings back Terrence Malick, who takes 5 years to make a movie, and this is a movie with Brad Pitt, Sean Penn, and dinosaurs. Don't know a thing about it, but I wouldn't miss it. Now, as we come to the end for Christmas Day, there is a movie called Alvin and the Chipmunks, The Squeakquel. The Squeakquel? The first movie was unendurable. So all I can say is,
we can hardly stand the wait. Please, Christmas, don't be late.
Please be late. Scumbucket for sure. I'm Peter Travers.